Oh, that is spicy.
It smells savory. What's up, everyone? I'm Chris. We've got Steph behind the camera, and we're hungry to travel. We are here in the land of smiles, Bangkok, Thailand. The street food here is unparalleled when it comes to quality and choice. And when you hear the word street food, one of the first places that come to mind is Bangkok. And it's because it has one of the world's best street food scenes. We're smiling because we can't wait to taste all the yummy food. So let's get going.
Welcome to Thailand.
So big.
We're here for breakfast for kho khamu, which is a braised pork knuckle. Now look at the size of this guy. It's braised in a 5-spice broth, and there were so many sitting in there braising and boiling and just soaking up all the delicious juices and flavors. This looks incredible. We've got it with a side of rice and some pickled greens, as well as a bit of chilies and garlic. Our kho khamu here comes with everything, the bone, the skin. Oh wow, look at that, just how tender it is. Oh my gosh, it's just falling off the bone. Look at that. All the fat, the pork fat, oh my goodness. Talk about a rich breakfast. Look at that meat and the skin there. Mmm. Oh my gosh. So rich. Such a strong 5-spice flavor, but with just the juices and the fattiness of the pork, the meat is so tender, not dry, lovely and juicy. Mmm. And the skin with that as well. It's kind of gelatinous, but the texture is so good with the meat. Look how tender that meat is. It literally just falls apart. Oh my gosh. It's incredible. Just a bit of rice, some of these greens. Mmm. The greens are a nice light addition to it, honestly. Kind of a nice bit of crunchiness to the softness of the meat. Just so rich and flavorful. Mmm. You could honestly just eat this like a soup. And interestingly enough, there's actually a bit of a sweetness to it as well. Ooh. Oh my gosh. Look at the skin and all the fat there. Oh my gosh. Just marinating in that 5-spice sauce. It really has penetrated like every single part of the dish here, you can see. Mmm. Honestly, it's really, really nice. It's very, very soft. It just really melts in your mouth and has so much flavor from marinating. This is amazing. Never quite had something like this for breakfast, but I don't see why not, because this is perfect. This is so perfect. Aroy. Delicious. So good. So tasty.
Thank you. All right, Max.
Bye-bye.
What amazing hospitality, such delicious food, just the perfect way to start our day.
Oh, we've heard about these little Thai dumplings called saku sai mu. They're like little pork and peanut filled tapioca dumplings, and looks like we found the place that makes them. So this is saku sai mu, which is a tapioca dumpling. And look at how beautiful these are. Such colorful dumplings. So we got two different types here. We got one that's made with tapioca balls, and the other one you saw them make it with a tapioca starch. And inside is a peanut, pork, and radish mixture. Oh wow, so you can see that there. You can see the peanuts in there. Smells savory. The tapioca starch is nice and chewy, but the inside filling, nice crunchy peanuts, and kind of like a savory sweet pork flavor, almost kind of like pork jerky. That is tasty. So it comes with a bag of lettuce and looks like garlic chips in there as well, so you can kind of eat the dumpling as a wrap. So I'm gonna take one of these tapioca ball dumplings. You can see all the little tapioca circles in there. And the filling is the same with the radish, pork, and peanut filling. Ooh, those garlic chips, I can smell them already. This is gonna be good. Look at that. Oh, arroy mac. Oh, arroy mac. So tasty and delicious. The tapioca ball dumpling is a lot chewier than the one that was cooked on with the tapioca starch. The lettuce adds kind of like a veggie dimension to the dumpling. It almost gives it kind of like a little bit of a bitter flavor, but with the sweet and the salty from the pork and the peanuts, it actually mixes together all really well. And they're made in such a cool and interesting way. So unique, such a unique street food this is. These are tasty. So cool.
On this super hot day, we really needed a cold drink to cool us off, and what is amazing here is the Thai iced tea. Look at the color of that, the orange. Ooh, I think this is gonna be perfect. Oh yeah, nice rich tea, but sweet from the condensed milk. The perfect caffeine and sugar kick to keep this day going. Let's go. There really is so much street food here in Thailand. You can't go more than about 100 meters without there being someone else at a cart selling something that smells and looks delicious. We're gonna try something now that is from northeastern Thailand that is a little healthy and a lot of spicy.
So many ingredients?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
We're here at Som Tam Jeso for papaya salad or Som Tam. Now, tam means pounded, which is the way they actually make the papaya salad. And it's one of the four categories of Thai foods. This dish looks amazing. We've got the fresh green papaya. There is lime, fresh lime, peanuts, the dried shrimp, fish sauce, chili. There is just loads here. Tomato looks amazing. And we also got some gai yang, which is a grilled chicken to go with it because it's the best thing to eat with the papaya salad. So got ourselves a pretty good meal here. Oh wow, look at all these fresh ingredients. Oh, we've got some chilies in there as well. I'm sure it's gonna be spicy. Oh, and also the beans, the fresh beans. Oh man, this is a feast of freshness. Mm. Oh, that is spicy. Super nice and crunchy. The fresh green papayas. But oh my goodness, that is so spicy. Because the chilies are just like raw, not cooked or anything, and you have just that super spicy, raw spiciness of it. Papaya salad is probably one of the spiciest things out there, but it's really nice with the fish sauce and everything because you've got the sourness from the lime, the saltiness from the fish sauce, the sweetness from, I believe, the palm sugar that they put in there, So you have so many nice flavors as well as the spiciness. Oh.
Aroika.
So tasty, oh my goodness. Pounding everything together with the mortar and pestle actually really brings out the flavors. It really amplifies it, especially the chilies. With the raw papaya, it just takes it to another level. Want to get a nice bite of this gaiyang, this lovely grilled chicken. I think this will pair perfectly with the papaya salad. Ooh, it's got a sweetness actually to it. Oh, that's lovely. That actually does go really, really well with it. Look at that, the bone just fell right out. So juicy. Look at that. Just how lovely and juicy it is in there. Wow. That's a really good chicken wing. Lovely and sweet to go with this spicy papaya salad. That's a really nice combo. What I love about the papaya salad is all the fresh ingredients. The papaya, the beans, the tomatoes, just everything is so nice and crunchy, and the chilies, it actually makes it pretty spicy. It's more tingly than hot. Taking a nice little stroll through Lumpini Park, which is one of the biggest parks in Bangkok, and it's beautiful. There's so much green space and so much area to walk around. It's a really, really nice break from the hustle and bustle of Bangkok.
Wow, 20 years?
Yeah, from my parents.
Oh, like, wow.
Take over from my parents.
Doing this?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
There's a super busy street food cart behind us that is selling punim tod, which is fried soft shell crab.
They look delicious.
Look at the size of these guys. They're actually like really big.
Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
Comes with like a red chili sauce, I think.
Yeah, maybe like a coconut chili sauce? I don't know.
Super crispy.
That's nice.
That's tasty.
And that's not too spicy actually.
No.
It kind of has a sweetness to it.
It's like a sweet chili sauce. And the crab, yeah, it's soft shelled, but it's nice and crispy because it's fried.
Yeah, it's really soft and really thin. And look at that. There's actually so much meat in there. And the crab, the shell layer, super, super thin. Wow, these are actually like stuffed with meat in the center.
There's a lot of crab in them.
The body.
Oh, I'm gonna get me another one because those are tasty. Wow, look how big these crabs are.
And honestly, it is crazy busy. When we got here a little while ago, it was like a massive pile of everything and it slowly dwindled down and there's always a lineup. Mm-hmm. So I have a feeling that other people have discovered her delicious softshell crab other than us.
There's a reason why there's a line. Mm-hmm. It's delicious. These are yummy.
They're actually really, really good. But as delicious as they are, I'm pretty sure I saw some mango sticky rice around the corner over here, which is kind of my favorite, so see you later. Here it is! Told you there was mango sticky rice.
Khao khun khap.
Thank you so much, khao khun khap. Dun, da, da, da. Here we have the mango sticky rice. I love mango sticky rice, so I'm super excited for this. So what it is we have our bottom layer of rice, which is glutinous sticky rice, and it is made with coconut milk and salt and sugar, which absorbs into the rice, which makes it super tasty, covered with an extra portion of coconut cream, mango, and these little mung beans on top. Pretty much for the ultimate dessert, or as I would like to say, any type of day meal. So let's just dig right in. Oh, that mango is so soft, and he put a whole entire mango on top of this, so that is when you know it's good. Look at that. Oh, it is so sticky with the coconut cream on top. Oh my gosh. It's like heaven. Rice, super sticky, wonderful texture, kind of chewy, but not too much. The mung beans on top are nice and hard, which gives a nice texture with the mango, which is super soft and ripe. And the coconut cream on top, it's lovely. And you know what? It does, you can really taste the sweet and saltiness of it. Oh wow, look how soft and ripe that mango is. So sweet, so ripe. That is delicious. Oh my gosh. For 100 Thai baht, I think we're gonna need to eat this every single day. Every day.
You can see at nighttime here in Bangkok, the streets are filled with street hawker stalls. There's people everywhere eating all sorts of things, and it's even livelier than it is during the day. Steph had her mango sticky rice, so let's go see if we can find me some dinner. Thai style omelet. Yes. So with the Thai style omelet here, you can pick any of the ingredients you want and he'll put it into the omelet. So I think we're gonna have to make an ultimate omelet. We're gonna definitely have to get some imitation crab meat. Let's just like pack that in there. Cup and cup. So it's 2 eggs?
Yeah.
Wow. That's cool. Ultimate omelet. Cup and cup. Here's our Thai style omelet. It looks nice and fluffy and fried. And what makes the Thai omelet special is that it's cooked with green onions and fish sauce as well to give it that really Thai flavor to it. And the Thai style omelet traditionally is served on a bed of rice as well. So you got a whole ton of white rice underneath. I'm just gonna take a bite of the omelet here. Nice and fluffy. Smells so good. Mmm. Ooh. I had a chili there. Not spicy. The pork I put in there is nice and salty. The egg is fluffy, not too oily and fried, even though he kind of cooks it with oil. It's not, doesn't have a really oily taste to it. Mmm. That's a really tasty omelet. Nice hot steaming rice there. Mmm. I got a piece of imitation crab there. That is the best. My favorite thing ever. You really taste the fish sauce in the omelet as well. Gives it that nice kind of Asian omelet taste to it. Wow, look at all that. So much egg. It looks like so much more than two eggs, which is what he put in there. You can see there's my imitation crab meat there. The green onion. It's piping hot too. Mmm. This is definitely the best way to end our Bangkok street food tour today. Eggs. All right, everyone, that does it for our Bangkok street food tour today. The street food in the city is on another level. We hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below and let us know what your favorite food was, and make sure you subscribe to our channel to join us on our next food adventure. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.